Hi, it's Diana. Trying to get used to my progressive lenses, and they are kind of annoying me. So I might be out of focus because I can't really tell. Okay, so here we are with the analysis part of the two gingerbread stories. And I'm just going to say it. I couldn't find any really, I don't have a very solid analysis going here. So what I did when I was thinking about that, had a little oh my goodness moment. And what am I going to do? I'm already all in. I can't abandon ship or abandon gingerbread. And who would want you anyway? It's too yummy. So what I did instead was think about the questions that came up. And for me, okay, I think I found the sweet spot with my, so if I do this, then I don't have to look down my nose to see if I'm in focus. Focused, blurry. Focused, blurry. So what I did, and when I do analysis, usually it starts with questions. And I've said that before, it starts with questions or things that I think are different or interesting. And I kind of, have those in my head. So, or really if it's a longer book, I've written in the margins because I am a big annotator. I'm a big annotator. That took a while to get, okay, anyway, that's another thing. So here are some of the questions I came up with the gingerbread stories. Why a gingerbread person? So that's the gingerbread man. Why a gingerbread person? So one thing I noticed in both stories is that kids get eaten, or they get there's an attempt to eat them. Now one of them's a cookie, but he still acts like a kid. He talks, he runs, he doesn't do what he's told, and has a lot of energy. And the other, the two kids don't get eaten, but they are the witch tries to eat them. So there's a whole thing about being consumed, children being consumed. I'm trying to think of stories where people, kids, are consumed, and I got a little list going, and I realized they're all fairy tales. Interesting. We don't so much write about that now, or do we? If you know of one, put it in the comments. I am not going to feature people as a food. And then for, I think I mentioned this, where gingerbread has a very strong smell. And even after it's baked, because when things are hot. And so that would attract attention. It would attract attention with the gingerbread kid running along. Not just that he taunts the creatures, but also his smell. Sounds funny. And then the kids walking through, the Hansel and Gretel walking through the forest would be attracted by the scent of the house. So that's a reason to have gingerbread, because it smells really good and it's strong. Speaking of strong, it's also a, sounds strange, building cookie, where if you watch, here we have a gingerbread house building competition, and they have really big ones. This one's not very big, but if you are a Great British Bake Off fan, whenever they have to construct anything out of biscuit, a lot of people choose gingerbread. It's a strong building cookie biscuit. So it could build a house. Though I did wonder, what happens when it rains or snows? Or why don't the animals eat it? Maybe she's constantly making gingerbread bricks and fixing her house. Let's see if I've gotten everything. Oh, to me, gingerbread is a special occasion cookie. And I kind of talked about that too, where I have a low tolerance, not tolerance, I have a low discipline threshold when it comes to gingerbread. And so I just bake it once a year. So then it has become, for me, a holiday cookie. It has significance. It has a place. It's part of the ritual. It's part of the Well, it's not ritual. What is it? Tradition. It's part of our tradition. So there's that. What does that have to do with the stories? That's what I'm bringing to the stories, that this is traditional. I was also expect, if you hear gingerbread house, I expect it to look cute. Let me look at the pictures of the gingerbread house in the book. I think it is cute. Well, you don't get a look. Okay, so yeah. So here's her gingerbread house. Even has gingerbread people on it. There's more of them. Oh yeah, over here. And there's a little chipmunk thingy, but he's not eating the. And now I'm thinking of my squirrels. The squirrels in my yard would absolutely be eating the cookie. I feel very, like my analysis this with the gingerbread, of which I was so excited about, is flat. Here, I just thought of something else. These are both kids' stories. They're stories for kids and they feature gingerbread. Maybe it being a gingerbread boy gives him permission to be sassy. He gets to say, I'm not gonna do what you want me to do. I'm gonna run away. And I'm gonna taunt you. Run, run, as fast as you can. You can't catch me. I might be little, I might be a cookie. But look at his little, look how he's doing it. He is very sassy. Run, run. I might be a cookie, I might be small. You might have made me. But I have will, and I'm going to run away from you. Well, that's something. You know, that's also kind of something in the, it's like a journey of discovery. That is my new phrase. It's a journey of discovery. In Hansel and Gretel, where the kids seem to be at the mercy of all the adults, first of their father and their stepmother who abandoned them in the forest. I don't care whose idea it was. I don't care if it was the stepmother's idea, the father went along. Okay, I just had to interject that. To abandon them in the forest. And the kids, they try to assert their will with the pebbles and finding their way back and then the breadcrumbs, but they're still at the mercy of the adults. And then when they're finding their way through the woods and they find the gingerbread house, and it seems like it's going to be a comforting, embracing little old woman who is just going to take care of them, again, at the mercy of the adult who now is going to eat them and makes Gretel work and puts Hansel in a cage. But the kids again assert their will, where Gretel pushes the witch into the oven and they get home. So two stories. What does that have to do with cookies? I think in the Gingerbread Man, maybe it gives him the permission. It gives him permission to be sassy. And to do what he wants. And what about in the... Well, it doesn't have to be the same thing. They're two different stories. Gingerbread is just enticing. Maybe that's it. It's they left a house where they knew they weren't wanted because they could hear the adults saying they weren't wanted, where they knew they were a burden because they could hear the adults saying, we can't even eat ourselves, have enough food to eat ourselves. That sounds like I'm saying they're going to eat themselves. We certainly can't feed the kids to a house that looks like abundance because the whole house is edible. But then they become the food. It doesn't matter how much they want to eat. In fact, the witch overfeeds Hansel so that he will get fat. So there's plenty of food. I mean, I'm going to do the feast too, because also one thing I noticed about the feast is that it's a pig. So they have a feast. And the part of the meat is a pig's head. Now, where I come from, I think that's a loaf of bread, not a ham. But there's the pig's head. Where I come from, we eat a thing called hogshead cheese, or I used to eat it. I don't eat pork anymore. And it's actually kind of yummy. It sounds horrible. It doesn't look appetizing, but it's really yummy. So anyway, there's not a lack of food where they end up. And that's shown by the house, which the whole house is edible. But it still doesn't solve their problem of needing adults to care for them because they're small. Well, that was an all over the place, very PC, me trying to make this work, analysis. I still feel like, and on that journey of discovery, I do feel like I understand the books a little more, that being a cookie boy gives this gingerbread boy permission to be sassy and to run away and assert his will, though at the end he gets eaten. Maybe by the end we're tired of him being so sassy. And then the gingerbread here is the journey of the kids needing adults to care for them. And they go from want, where there's nothing, there's not enough for everybody to eat, to a place where there's an abundance of food, even the house is edible. And not just edible, but edible dessert, edible cookies. It's not the main meal. And still, that's not what they really need. What they really need is for an adult to care for them. Okay, I'm happy with those answers. I'll probably put some slides in to put my more formulated thoughts down. And and then we're on to poem, not written for kids, The Emperor of Ice Cream. Bye, see y'all next time.